Hey guys, welcome back to James, the instruction book, the how-to book on how to live as a Christian. Today, James is going to give us some instructions. I've got them up here. Now, you might have a title above yours. We're in chapter 5 today, verse 7 through 12. And my title right above verse 7 says, Patience in Suffering. So instructions James is going to give us today, be patient, don't grumble, don't swear, let your yes be yes, don't exaggerate. So I love how it starts off by talking about something, how he compares, how he uses an example of a farmer and a Christian. So that's what we're going to talk about today on James. Okay, well, here we go. In James, he starts off chapter 5, verse 7, by saying, be patient. It's instructions. It's not a suggestion. Be patient then, brothers, until the Lord's coming. So he's telling us to be patient until the great harvest. Be patient until the Lord comes back. And then he uses this example. See how the farmer waits for the land to yield its valuable crop and how patient he is for the autumn and the spring rains? You too be patient and stand firm because the Lord's coming is near. Don't grumble against each other, brothers, or you will be judged. The judge is standing at the door. So he's right there. We're waiting for him to come back. But he's right there, lock and loaded, waiting to come back. So he's saying, be patient. You know, and what we're doing during this time, I love when he uses the farmer analogy here, because basically what we're doing is planting seeds. We're planting seeds for the great harvest. Not that we don't see growth in this time. He wants us to see growth. We want to grow, but the great harvest is when that eastern sky splits and the trumpet sounds and the Lord comes back. He's at the door. So he's at the door watching, so don't grumble. He's there. He's closer than you think is what James is saying. But he says both farmer and Christian must live by faith. Well, why do I have to live by faith? Well, a farmer has to be patient. So not only do you have to work the ground, clear the ground, cultivate the ground, plow the ground, diss the ground, and then put seeds in it, but then you got to wait. It's not like you can come out the next day and say, well, nothing happened overnight. Be patient. A lot has to happen. That seed that was put in the ground has to die before there's life. It has to rot. It has to get moisture in it. It has to start decaying, and then life happens. And seeing that happens in ourselves too. We have to die to self before we can grow. You know, we have to rot. Our old self has to die away and be, as the Bible tells us, be born again. That seed is dead. Can't do anything until you mix it with something. You mix it with the sun. You mix it with water, right? And something happens, the moisture. I like the analogy of the baptism of being the water and the sun being the S-O-N, sun, the Son of God. The Holy Spirit comes over us and we're born again and we start growing. So be patient with yourselves in growing. Be patient with others. Remember where you were at one time. And you might be ahead of somebody spiritually and they might not be moving as quick as you, but maybe you didn't move as quick as you thought you did. Maybe ask some people that were praying for you or that has been walking the walk with you. Sometimes we just want them to catch up with us so quickly. So we have to be, both farmer and Christian must live by faith, by planting seeds. You can't make it happen any sooner. You, as a Christian, you can't make God come back, you know, Jesus come back any quicker. As a farmer, you can't make the corn, if you plant a seed of corn, you can't make it grow any faster. There's a harvest time. And when you know that and you're working towards that, then something amazing happens. So we can't make it any happen for growth. We can't make it any faster for Christ's return. We can't hurry through the process. So there's a process. But When we have faith and work, like there will be a harvest, when we have that faith and work, James talks about both faith and works, right? That you got to do something with it because you know there's going to be a harvest. So what do we have to do? We plant seeds. We plant seeds in others. Now, I'm going to come back to that, but let me go along a little further in that where it says 9 again. It says, don't grumble against each other. So be patient towards each other. Don't grumble against each other. It's going to get hot. Things are going to happen. Things are going to get heated up. But don't grumble because there will be a harvest. And he's at the door and he's watching. He's at the door and he's watching. I love that. The judge is standing at the door. Well, what is the door? Well, what is the door? It's an entranceway, right? And an exit. So exit out of this earth, enter into heaven. He's right there when heaven and earth are going to come together. So remember that. You know, in this time that we've been going through this year, well, there's always something going on. Is this a little different? Yeah, it's impacted a lot of people. It impacted the world. A pandemic impacts the world. And but so does Christ. He goes on in verse 10 and says, brothers, as an example of patience in the face of suffering, take the prophets who spoke in the name of the Lord. As you know, we consider blessed those who have persevered. You have heard of Job's perseverance and have seen what the Lord finally brought about. The Lord is full of compassion and mercy. When we see it, many of you have been through trials. You have been through things that have happened, but you've seen what's come out on the other side. Sometimes we can't always say you can't. We know God's hand is on it, but we can't always trace it. That's the perseverance that we come through. Things are always going to happen, but remember, there's going to be a harvest, and he's at the door. He is near, and he's watching. In verse 12, it says, above all, my brothers, do not swear, not by heaven or by earth or by anything else. Let your yes be yes and your no be no, or you will be condemned. You know, your yes be yes and your no be no. You know, don't exaggerate. Make sure people, when you speak, they know that when he says something, it's going to happen. When she says no, it means no. When she says yes, it means yes. By your word, make sure your word is good so they believe you. Because if they don't believe you by actions, how are they going to believe you if you start witnessing to them? Let your yes be yes. And don't swear by anything. You know, it's by anything false. There's no need to do that. You know, the thing I want to come back to is when he says, brothers, by an example, you know, patience in the face of suffering. Think about times in your discussion time. Think about times when people had suffered and you saw something good come out of the other side, because God can make all things good. He can bring all things together for good. So I want you to share some of your own stories and just think about those. Think about those things that has happened by example. So when you're talking to somebody else and you're putting yourself in this and you're telling people, be patient, plant seeds, wait. But we know there's a harvest coming. It's not wait and do nothing. The farmer still does something. He doesn't take the summer off. There's plenty of things to do until the harvest comes. Now, the things we can do, we can plant seeds. We can pass out the gospel of John and explain it to people. We can share the gospel with others based on our understanding. This book of James, the biggest part of it is coming together so we can discuss. So if you're in a group or you share the video with somebody else or you watch it with somebody else, what a great time to Zoom somebody and then play the video and watch it and go through it with them. Get in the Word with them. I hope you have a good study Bible, because you can pick up a good study Bible. A lot of times I recommend the Life Application Study Bible, because you can go through it. You can pick a book to go through. You can pick a chapter or some scripture to go through with somebody and then go to the index where it's given you some examples, or sometimes it even asks questions. You know, a lot of times when I study, I'll have three different study Bibles laying out because of how it challenges me, how it explains things in a way that I wouldn't have explained them, and also put it into great practice right now. So when we're reading this, both the farmer and the Christian must have faith and work like there's going to be a harvest. So we're called to do things, to share the faith, not keep it, but to share the faith. So through your discussion time, there's a lot of things to unpack there. Just read through it and just see what questions the Holy Spirit gives you to bring out to where you can take instruction and do this, to be patient, not grumble, don't swear. Let your yes be yes. And at the same time, not hurry in the process, but actually working through the process, because He is coming. He's at the door. He's closer than we think. So there's work to be done. There's seeds to be planted. So talk about that, examples of perseverance, of going through, and also maybe some examples of how you can be, what the works would look like, you know, because that's how you have faith. And in it, when it doesn't look good, when you say, well, I've been out witnessing and I've been inviting people to Bible study. I've been inviting people to meet with me. I've been inviting them. Don't grumble amongst yourself. Just be patient and be in prayer about those things that you're doing. God will show up. He will, because His Word says He will. Amen? Amen. Have a great time having a discussion, and give me some feedback. And maybe you can leave some comments underneath, or you can get a hold of me at Tim Hartledge at hopecma.com. Look forward to hearing from you. God bless.